Okay, go away. Hey guys, Matt, IronTrap Garage, and today we're gonna be working on the 32-3 window project. I know it's been like 32 land lately, but we're getting into some cool projects that we finally are able to work on. So in the last video, we kind of threw in the suspension under it and made it a roller, so to speak. I use that loosely. We have the suspension underneath and kind of bolted in. The engine and trans are just kind of, they were literally just sitting in there, like rocking all around with straps and different things. And I want to get this car so that we can actually roll it around the shop safely without the engine and trans just toppling over and hurting someone. And I want to see if we can get this engine and trans to sit in the stock engine bay location. So get a firewall in this. We're going to build some motor mounts and trans mounts for this. And we also have to swap the transmission around to put a torque tube converted 37 LaSalle behind this big old Lincoln Y-block engine. So let's get started. All right, so took a little break over the holiday weekend, but you guys saw there was a couple shots there that I got some things mocked up. I did a little bit off camera that I wanted to show real quick. So I ended up swapping out that trans. That is a 37 LaSalle trans still, but it's been shortened. The tail shaft was shortened and it actually has been converted to use a Ford torque tube connection here with the U-joint. It was re-splined. It's kind of an old-time thing that was done to these LaSalles, and I'm lucky enough that I have some stashed away. So when we did the trans, or did the mock-up, we used just this engine and trans just to, for space, but obviously that tail shaft's really long and it's for open drive, and since we're running that chrome banjo rear, I wanted to run this in here and start setting everything in place. So we got the engine all centered and squared up, ended up only having to trim just a tiny bit at the bottom of the firewall down here. Just to clear the bell housing, that big truck bell housing that's on this Lincoln engine. And basically the firewall fit. We have it pushed back essentially as far as it can go without major modifications. It's kind of tight at this at the right bank here on the firewall. So I may need to just trim this edge just a tiny bit. Again, stuff that's hidden, so that makes me kind of happy the way I did these mock-up of the engine mounts, kind of using old Hurst mounts as a inspiration. If they would have made mounts for these, what would they have looked like? So I went and looked at the Schroll Coupe that has an old set on it and kind of copied the concept. So I have these made out of chipboard here. It's actually utilizing the original motor mount locations for a 32 Ford, which kind of, again, makes me kind of happy. So with that and some spacers, we can make it all work with factory parts, which is really cool. So I need to cut these out of some plate. I have some quarter inch plates set up over here, and I'm gonna move this stuff and get this cut with the plasma cutter over here. And this is some quarter inch plate, you know, weld all these pieces together, take my patterns, and we should have motor mounts here soon after some cutting, welding, and drilling.
If you go to 1930 on U-Haul, there was only three car brands: Chevrolet, Ford, and Plymouth back then. Mm-hmm. Model A truck. Thank you.
right, so got my trans belts. I threw them in the blaster just so they weld a little better, and also just to get them all cleaned up and looking a little better. So I'm ready to kind of tack weld these things in. So I know people yell, get in a lot of videos, why aren't you using your lift? Well, in this particular instance, we definitely want to set the car on the ground with the weight on everything to set our engine trans up. If my chassis table wasn't currently being used, we could have used it for that, but it is what it is. So I have everything set up. I checked the level on the back of the trans here, which is good. It's centered. We're happy with where everything's at. So I'm gonna get a couple good tack welds. I'm using a MIG welder. People ask that a lot of times. Why do I use the TIG over the MIG, etc. In instances like this where I just want to get in a tight area and tack something or weld something that's hard to get in, it's much easier with a MIG welder to get in. So I probably will end up finish welding it with the TIG. I'm not sure yet, but in this instance, I can just get my hand in there and get a couple handful of really good tacks in there, and that will hold the weight for us continuing the project. So did the final step here and put the grill and the radiator back on in the stock location, and we checked and everything is looking good as it was before we did the final welding. Really happy with how this engine fits. There is just enough room that we could fit a flat fan on the front of this water pump. So everything should work out really, really nicely as far as fitment. I can't believe that this thing fit. Like when we first started messing with this engine, I'm like, oh my God, this. We have to cut the firewall way back and set the engine back, but with moving stuff around and playing with everything, we were able to just get it to fit. Like I mentioned earlier in the video, I may have to notch the firewall a tiny bit, possibly. We have a little bit of play in our motor mounts that we can slide this back just a tiny bit. So we may put a little notch there, so if we need the fan clearance, we can slide it back a little bit. But everything's sitting, it's on its own weight, it's bolted in. Pretty crazy, this pile of parts that we had laying at the warehouse and laying around the shop, we've kind of thrown together, and we have a pretty bitchin' 32-3 window. It's kind of crazy that it's come along with just a, I don't know, we have maybe three sessions of working on this car. I call sessions, that means like multiple days. A session can last a week. But three sessions or videos essentially of working on this thing, and we have a engine bolted in, body's on, looking kind of how it's going to look. It's pretty kick-ass. So that's the last probably big update on this car for a little while. We're going to be putting this thing away. Reason I was working on this is I wanted to make it mobile, get the engine bolted in so we can actually put this one away, bring the 33-3 window down, because this winter we're going to probably start working pretty heavily on that again. But now we have this car in a state that we can roll it around and move it around the property or the shop pretty easily, which is the most important thing when you have as many projects as we do. So thank you guys for following along. Let me know what you think of the Lincoln Y-block in the three window and how everything's shaped up. Thanks, guys. Catch you later.